welcome to this introduction and installation tutorial for Sloan's new EBV550A Dual Flush Side Mount Flushometer. Sloan's complete line of retrofit flushometer products bring convenience and other advantages of sensor-activated, hands-free flushing to commercial restrooms. The EBV550A Dual Flush Side Mount Flushometer for water closets offers additional benefits. The dual flush side mount is a battery-powered unit that can be retrofitted onto most Sloan manual flushometers as well as many competitive manual flush valves. Because the dual flush unit uses batteries instead of a hardwired connection, it's the ideal choice for restroom renovations and upgrades. Installing a dual flush side mount upgrades the restroom by converting a manual flushometer to a sensor-activated, more water-efficient flushometer. Sloan's dual flush side mount utilizes its patented smart sense technology to control the amount of water delivered to the fixture. Once the infrared sensor detects a restroom user, it calculates the amount of time the user is present to deliver either a full or reduced flush. The restroom visitor can also choose to flush manually. Pushing the green button initiates the reduced 1.1 GPF flush. If the larger black button is pushed, the unit will deliver a full 1.6 GPF flush. The larger black button has true mechanical override, or TMO, functionality. That means that even when the batteries wear out and the electronic sensor fails to operate the flushometer, the TMO button will enable the user to manually flush the fixture. Sloan's TMO is a non-hold open TMO, meaning that no matter how long the button is pushed, that it will only deliver the amount of water equal to one flush. The dual flush side mount also features Sentinel Flush, which automatically initiates a flush every 72 hours of non-use. This helps keep the fixture fresh and the system operating effectively. The dual flush side mount has a chrome-plated metal housing, which has a durable, attractive, long-lasting finish. The unit is tested to IP46, meaning it is effective in providing both dust and water resistance. This helps ensure the inner electronics will be protected during normal use and maintenance. But not all applications require the dual flush. The primary difference is in the programming of the smart sense technology. The single flush side mount delivers one volume of water, depending on the flushometer diaphragm kit installed. It functions well on both closets and urinals. The single black button still functions as a true mechanical override, allowing for manual flushing if the user prefers or if the battery power fails. Both Sloan's dual flush side mount and single flush side mount have a 3-year limited warranty. This provides peace of mind and reinforces the quality and dependability you expect from Sloan. Now that we've reviewed the features and benefits, let's turn to the simple steps required to install the Sloan dual flush side mount. To start, you will need an Allen wrench and the bushing sleeve assembly, which is an important part of the dual flush retrofit kit. The unit can be mounted on either the left side or the right side of the flushometer, depending on your orientation. First, wrap a towel around the bottom to catch any water that might spill out of the handle. Then, shut the water off. It is not necessary to shut off the water when removing the handle of a manual flush valve, but it is recommended. Remove the spinning cover with a flathead screwdriver and turn the screw while flushing. Then, flush again. Keep pushing the handle until you don't hear anything. That helps make sure there's no buildup pressure in the valve. Included in the box is a simple wrench to remove the handle coupling and replace it with the side mount kit. Keep the wrench for future use. Get the handle loose and take it off. Sometimes you may have some water dripping out. Make sure you save the handle. Remove the bushing and the Allen wrench from the package. The Allen wrench is for the battery on the side. When you're looking at the bushing sleeve assembly from the back, you'll see a flat spot on the top next to a notch mark, and there's a notch on the other side. The flat spot and the notches on the bushing will line up with corresponding marks on the dual flush retrofit kit. When installing the bushing, the notch faces up. Because this unit is being installed on the left side, the flat spot is facing up. As you push it on there, you'll feel it locking it right onto the notch. Give it a simple twist to verify that it's locked onto the notch. Now, mount the unit onto the side of the valve and hand tighten the coupling. Finish tightening with the provided wrench. Make sure it's snug. Remove the cover over the sensor that has been protecting it from scratches. After the sticker has been removed, the unit will give you 3 minutes to clear the area before it begins its startup mode. Notice the green flashing light, which means that the unit is going through its range adjustment settings. The unit will go through 150 seconds of slow, double flashing, followed by 10 seconds of fast, double flashes. There will be a slight pause, and then 12 to 15 seconds of very fast flashing. Once it's done calibrating, it will follow with 3 slow flashes and activate a flush. Put your hand in front of the unit as a test. After 8 seconds, you'll see 3 slow flashes, indicating that it has detected a target. Remove your hand, and the unit will cycle. On the dual flush unit, there are green and black buttons. The green button is smaller, which is the reduced flush. The larger black button is for the full flush. The black button is also a true mechanical override used in case the batteries are no longer functioning. When you press the black button, you're actually pushing the plunger to activate the flush. Once you've gone through the startup sequence, turn the water back on by turning the screwdriver to the left until the unit flushes. When a target is in front of the sensor for at least 8 seconds, but less than 60 seconds, the unit will automatically initiate the reduced flush after a 3-second delay. Staying in front of the unit longer than 60 seconds will start the full flush. When it's time to change the batteries, a red light will flash on the sensor. Batteries are estimated to last 3 years, depending on how often the unit is used. The unit uses 4 C-cell batteries, which are in a battery tray. Provided with the unit is an Allen wrench for removing the batteries from the tray at the side of the valve. The screw doesn't fall out, it just loosens. Notice the battery door starting to pop out. When the screw starts to skip, that means it's out of its threads. And you can grab the battery door and slide it out. Once you have put the new batteries in the tray, slide it in and tighten with the wrench. The tray will pull in. You don't have to push it in. As soon as the battery tray makes contact, the unit enters its startup mode. During the flashing, stand to the side or exit the stall. This completes our overview of the EBV550A Dual Flush Flushometer unit. If you have questions, please call Sloan Customer Service or our technical support team at 800-982-5839 or visit our website at www.sloanvalve.com. Thank you.